agenda is a jobs boom that is historic. And we just passed the largest package of tax cuts and reforms in American history. The largest.
There you got the president in the panhandle of Florida last night touting his economic success, including tax reforms, which helped a record, take a look, 41 states recover collections from the recession, revenue-wise. Despite this, some states still face big obstacles. Pew finding 10 states consistently spending more than they're collecting. And what do they have in common? Most of the states are blue. Here to react, senior fellow of the National Taxpayers Union, Maddie Duppler. Maddie, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Why are the blue states having so much trouble?
Well, it's a tale as old as time, right? You spend more than you take in, you're going to have a deficit, you're going to have problems. Now, the question for the states is, why did the recovery take so long?
Right.
It's because we had bad federal policy at the federal level leading the way, but a lot of these states hadn't learned. Thanks to tax reform, it has forced a lot of these states to start realigning their budgets with what their actual fiscal expectations are. As a result, you saw that 41 states now have revenue streams that are coming in over those recession levels. That is
right.
So important. Important to get states back on healthy footing, but they won't stay there long if they can't get their spending obligations under
sure.
control.
And one of the obligations is pensions, and we've got a graphic that shows that on the big board. A local government contributions to pensions, $360 billion in 2007, and fast forward to today, $1.5 trillion.
Yep.
They made a lot of deals with people that they really can't keep, but they've got to by law.
Exactly. And when you talk about bad federal policy leading the way, this is a prime example of that. With the stimulus package and federal programs in the recession, what that did was that encouraged state and local mm-hmm. governments to hire
right.
at an expedited pace. That meant more employees, that meant more pensions. And of course, when those federal dollars ran out, states are on the hook for those liabilities.
Sure. Speaking of states, New York, where I'm sitting right now, saw personal income tax collections drop by 6.6% last year. One of the reasons is so many people who are doing well are saying, you know, enough with New York taxes. I'm
yep.
moving to Florida. I'm moving to Arizona.
Yep. Over the last 10 years, the counties that have grown the most are the ones that are sitting in states without income taxes. States like New York, Connecticut, California, they are seeing a shrinking tax base because, again, they're not learning their lesson. You need people there to pay taxes, but you can't punish them for being successful if you want them to stay.
Exactly. A cautionary tale. Maddie Duppler, we thank you very much for joining us live from our nation's
thank
capital
you.
Day. All right. What do you think about that? Email us, friends at Fox.